Namaskar student, today I will going to teach you few numericals from current electricity. So my first problem is, in a potentiometer arrangement, a cell of EMF 1.25 volt gives a balance point at 35 centimeter length of wire. If the cell is replaced by another cell and the balance point shift to 63 centimeter, what is the EMF of the second cell? So we know that according to potentiometer, the equation is E2 by E1 equals to L2 by L1. We have to find E2. Here already given E1 equals to 1.25 volt and length equals to 35 centimeter, and L1 35 centimeter, L2 already given 63 centimeter. So after putting all this value, we get this one, E equals to L2 by L1 equals into E1. So after putting all this value, we will get 2.25 volt. This is my problem number 2. The number density of a free electrons in a copper conductor is 8.5 × 10^28 m/m³. How long does the electron take to drift from one end of a wire 3 meter long to its other end? So we have to calculate drift velocity. The area of a cross section already given of a wire, this is 2 × 10^-6 meter square, and the carrying current of 3 ampere. So we know that the relationship between current and drift velocity, I equals to NEAVD. So here N equals to, already N given, N is free electron in a copper conductor, this one 8.5 × 10^28 m³. E already given, E is what we know, that the value of E 1.6 × 10^-19 coulomb. I already given, I equals to 3 ampere, and area of our cross section is 2.2 × 10^-6 meter square, and the length is 3 meter. So what is drift velocity? Drift velocity equals to VD equals to this one, I by N E A. VD equals to I by N E A. So here we know that the value of I already given, this is along the length, which is 3, and this is the value of I, 3 ampere. And N is what? N is equivalent to 8.5 × 10^-28, and E, we know that 1.6 × 10^-19, and this is A. So after calculating this value, we will get 1.1 × 10^-4 m/s. Here we have to find the time, okay, how long. So time equals to what? Time equals to T equals to L by VD. So we know that VD is drift velocity, the value is 1.1 × 10^-4 m/s, and the value of L already given, this is the 3 meter long wire. So 3 by 1.1 × 10^-4, which is equivalent to 2.27 × 10^4 s, or 7 hours 33 minutes. This is my third problem. The earth surface has a negative surface charge density of 10^-9 coulomb meter per meter square. The potential difference of 400 kV between the top of atmosphere and the surface result in a current of only 1800 ampere over the entire globe. If there were no mechanism of sustaining atmospheric electric field, how much time roughly would you require to neutralize the earth surface? And here this is the another part. This never happens in practice, because there is a mechanism to replenish electric charge, namely the continual thunderstorm and lightning in different parts of the globe. Here radius of the earth already given. So we know that already given the value of sigma equals to 10^-19. This is charge density, coulomb per meter square, and I already given I equals to 1800 ampere, and this is the radius of the earth. So we first of all we have to find what? We have to find the surface area of a globe. So this is a globe. So area is what? Pi, 4 pi r square. So here 4, and the value of pi 22/7 or 3.14, and r we know that r equals to 6.37 with inverse 6 square. So after calculating this value, we will gain 5.1 into inverse 40 meter square. Now we have to find the total charge of a globe. What is the total charge? Q equals to what? Sigma into A. A means area of that globe. Area of the globe. So sigma is equivalent to 10 to the power minus 9 and into 5.1 into 10 to the power 14. So after calculating this value, we will get 5.1 into 10 to the power 5 coulomb. Now we have to find what? We have to find this one. How much time would require to neutralize the earth's surface? So we have to find the value. We have to find how much time. So this is equivalent to T equals to Q by I, because Q equals to IT. So T equals to Q by I. Here Q equals to 5.1 raised to the power 5, and I already given 1800 ampere. So it is equivalent to 283 second or 4 minute 43 second. This is the roughly value. This is my fourth problem, and this is an unsolved problem. 6 lead acid types of secondary cells, each of EMF 2 volt and internal resistance 0.015 are joined. This is the resistance, so this is ohm, are joined in series to provide a supply to a resistance of 8.5 ohm. What are the current drawn from the supply and its terminal voltage? So you have to find the current drawn from the supply and you have to find the voltage. This is the next part. A secondary cell of after a long use has an EMF of 1.9 volt and a large internal resistance of 380 ohm. What maximum current can be drawn from the cell, and could the cell drive the starting motor of a car? So this is my fourth problem. So you have to put the equation and you will get the value. This is my fifth problem. Two wires of equal length of one of aluminium and the other of copper have the same resistance. Which of the two wires is lighter? Hence explain why aluminium wire are preferred for overhead power cables. So here already given what this is. This is equivalent to rho is given. Rho is equivalent to 2.63 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter, and this is the copper. This one for aluminium, the copper is 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. The relative density already given, which is equivalent to Al equals to 2.7 and Cu 8.9. So what is the equation? We know that resistance is proportional to the length and inversely proportional to the area of the cross section. So R equals to rho L by A. So this is the equation. And what is the mass of a wire? We know that mass equals to volume into density. So here ALD. So we have to put the value and we will get what is the mass. M equals to rho L R into LD. So rho L square D by R. Here the length of the resistance of a two wire are same. Look, length same. So we can write M by AL means mass of aluminium divided by mass of copper equivalent to R into D divided by R into D. So here what is the value of R and D? Here already given that this is equivalent to this is the value of rho. So 2.63 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter into the relative density 2.7 into 10 to the power 3, and this is equivalent to 1.72 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter, and this is 8.9 into 10 to the power 3. So after calculating this value, we will get 0.46. So this indicates that the aluminium wire is 0.4 times lighter than copper wire. So aluminium wire is lighter, that's why we prefer for overheat power cable. Aluminium wire are preferred for overheat power cable. This is my sixth problem. Given n resistor, each of resistance R, how will you combine them to get maximum and minimum effective resistance? What is the ratio of maximum and minimum resistance? And given the resistance of 1, 2, 3, how will you combine them to get the equivalent resistance 11.3 ohm, 11.5 ohm, 6 ohm, 6.11 ohm? And determine the equivalent resistance of network shown in the figure. So this is the figure. So here we know that for a maximum resistance, the resistor is connected with the resistance is NR, and if this one is a minimum resistance, then it is divided, means this, that means it is connected with parallelly, so R by N. So for the maximum, it is connected with series. So what is the ratio? Ratio is NR by R by N, which is equivalent to N square. So this is my first equation. This is the maximum, and for the minimum effective resistance, and this is the ratio of the maximum and minimum resistance. Now given the resistance 1 ohm, 2 ohm and 3 ohm, how will you combine them to get the equivalent resistance 11 by 3? First of all, 11 by 3, so if we want to combine this one, 3 ohm and 1 and 2, 3 ohm connected with series and 1 and 2 ohm connected with parallelly, then we will get this one 11 by 3 ohm. So 2 and 1 connected with parallelly, and after that 3 ohm connected with series. And next part is 11 by 5. 11 by 5 means 2 and 3 ohm connected with parallelly, and after that 1 ohm connected with series. This is the answer is 11 by 5. Next is 6 ohm. So 1, 2, 3, all the three resistance connected in series. So we will get 1 plus 2 plus 3, and this is 6 ohm. And next is 6 by 11 ohm, which is equivalent to if 1, 2, 3, both are these three resistance connected with parallelly, then we will get 6 by 11 ohm. Next part is what? Determine the equivalent resistance of network shown in the figure. So this is a figure, and we will find the equivalent resistance. So here given these are the 1, 1, 1, and this one is, or these all are 2 ohm. So here for the upper row, this is R1. So here 1, 1 and 1, so 1 plus 1, and here this one is for 2 plus 2, so 2 plus 2. So after that resistance, this 1 and 1 and 2 plus 2 connected with parallelly, this one and this one connected parallelly. So we will get what? 2 into 4, we know that 1 by R dash equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, this is equivalent to 4 by 3. And now we have 1, 2, 3 extra 3 part, like this 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have to multiply with 4, so it is equivalent to 16 by 3 ohm. And my next sum is this one, this is connected, okay? So so we have to find when the battery connected between A and B, this one A, this is A and this is B, and I current flows through it, for this resistance is 5. So this all are connected with series. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 5 ohm. Okay. So resistance is 5R. This is the equivalent resistance for this circuit. Now this is the problem number 7. This is also an unsolved problem. Determine the current drawn from a 12 volt supply with internal resistance 0.5 ohm by an infinite network shown in figure. Each resistor has 1 ohm resistance. So this is the figure. So you have to find the internal resistance, determine the current. Oh, you have to find the current. So you have to put the equation and you will get the value. This is problem number 8. So my problem number 8 is, given figure show a 2 volt potentiometer used for a determinations of internal resistance of a 1.5 volt cell. The balance point of a cell in open circuit is 76.3 centimeter. When a resistor of 9.5 ohm is used in an external circuit of a cell, the balance point shifts to 64.8 centimeter length of the potentiometer wire. Determine the internal resistance of a cell. So this is the figure. So what is the equation for internal resistance of a cell, which is equal to R equals to epsilon by V minus 1 into R. So here it is equivalent to length L1 by L2 minus R in minus 1 into R. So here already given length 1, L1 equals to 76.3 centimeter, and length 2 already given, this is 64.8 centimeter, and R already given, which is 9.5 ohm. So after putting all this value, we will get what? R equivalent to 76.3 by 64.8 minus 1 into 95. So after calculating this value, we will get 1.7 ohm. So this is the value of the resistance. So this is the value of the internal resistance of the cell. So thank you, student, for watching this video.